Hello, my kinder three childs, and I guess they another child for kinder. Today we're going to work an extra special artwork that is called a maritime landscape. So we're going to use this notebook that you have is marquilla. These notebooks have two different kinds of paper. You have the thin one. And this is the, it's not so thick and it's not so cool. We're going to use this. This board's great, really. Okay, so the first thing that we're going to use is this pencil. With this pencil, I'm going to draw different kinds of maritime creatures on my paper. Like this, simple. It's a jellyfish there, maybe a fish. Oh, some weeds here, it's always cool. And maybe a shark over here. Yeah, it's a very, very vicious and dangerous shark. Yeah, and here a starfish, and maybe like that. Remember that, be careful on the composition of your artwork. Yeah, it's it. I'm going to use my eraser, and I'm gonna erase that like that. With the trace. I want it to be not so erased, but I want to see the lines that I have traced. Don't erase too much. Yeah. And then I'm going to use my crayon. Yes? Look at this. Oh. We have a jellyfish, we have a fish, we have a shark, some weeds, and why not? And a starfish. So, I'm going to use my white crayon, or in this case, an oil pastel in white color. It's very important for this to be in white color, okay? We don't want another color, but it's not going to add the same effect. I'm going to line, I'm going to trace the same drawing that I have made before. Remember, professor have done it quickly because professor have more experience. Take your time. I'm going to trace here with the starfish, here with a little fish. Yeah, now the shark. God, look at this shark, it looks so dangerous. Okay, the giant smile. The seaweeds. And let's add some bubbles here. Bubbles are also, I always like to put some other shapes where they're not supposed to be there. Like a star and some dots. Ready. But professor, I don't see anything there. I know. Then we're going to take my watercolors like that. You have some of this. I really like the job mark because watercolors look so deeper than another. And I'm going to do this. I'm going to take a little bit of water with my brush and I'm going to spread on my paper, and then I'm going to take a little bit of this color and embrace the color of my artwork. Look the shapes. are appearing. That's so cool. But how I have did it? Well, the explanation for this is pretty simple. Well, looks like the water, it's always get imprint on the paper, but not in the paper where I have color with white crayon. Why? Because white crayon and oil pastels are made of oil-based colors and it doesn't get imprinted by water. Look, of course there I can add some another color, maybe some pink for this jellyfish. Well, I have blue, that's why it turns to purple, but I think that it's a great color. Are you liking it? Let me know. I'm going to check your comments later. Well, this fish is already blue, but if I want it to be in another color, I'm going to add some yellow on it. Now it's green. I'm going to spread more water here. Don't do it so quickly. Take your time. I'm adding different kind of blue or shades of blue here for make some contrast of the different tones of blue. Yeah. Wow. I really like it. Some military green here and some yellow for make light sense. And I'm going to finish that with a little bit of blue green here. And here you go, we have it. And you like it? So I know that you only can be so buried in house. Now you can create some other landscapes, maybe a cosmic one or a different kind of planet. I don't know. Use your imagination and remember, always be artistic.